How's it? This is Mundo. Happy 2022. Happy New Year. I've got a cool music amp here. It's an acoustic amplifier. BP40D is the model number. And full disclosure, they sent this to me to do a review. And I'm happy they did because I'm excited to share with you what I found on it. First and foremost, it is a battery-powered amp. And so just for that fact alone, this is going to be valuable. And I'll explain why. It came fully charged out of the box, and I haven't even charged it yet. I've been making friends with it. So we're 4 hours in, 5 hours of playing and just keeping it on, and it still has a charge. So how cool is that? So I think it gets, depending on the volume you use, you'll get 6 to 8 hours charge time. So you're not gonna have this die on you on a gig. And if you're at a gig with electricity, then just plug it in. But so many uses for this outside of always having available electricity. For instance, just practicing in the living room. You don't have to plug anything. You bring it to your couch, put it next to you, and just play away. How many writing sessions or living room rehearsals have you had? I've had many, so just take this. I've done some big gigs where, like with orchestras, and it's not all about the guitar on these gigs. You're just part of this big band. And sometimes you take multiple guitars and you have an acoustic guitar. And so I would use this maybe on the floor or on a stand. Check it out. You can use a speaker stand and just face it straight into my face so I can hear myself. And then take the DI out, which they have, and send that to the house. I did a gig just like that. Put the speaker facing me or off to the side. I had 4 horn players right behind me. It was so loud, but this helped me hear myself. I didn't have to bug the monitor guys so much. So that is awesome. And the main thing is playing outside, right? Busking, jamming. I did a gig for the city of Las Vegas last year and a city of Henderson. In both those gigs, we had to play outside. One of them we could bring a generator to, didn't have a generator, gas power generator, which means you set it far away so it doesn't make too much noise, and then you draw your power lines close to you. This would have been perfect. We opted just to play acoustically, and it was fine with my band, the Hot Club of Las Vegas, but when we started to get a crowd, we needed a little more volume, and this would have been perfect. So this is going to be super valuable. I mentioned that you can put it on a speaker stand, and when I take it outside, you'll see that it comes in under 16 pounds. My scale says it comes in under 15 pounds, but it's light. So if you're not so big or not so strong, pretty easy to put on a speaker stand. And musical instruments aside, it could just be a personal address system where you just make announcements through. And for the price point, I think $219, you get a lot of bang for your buck. I could see a lot of uses for this. It's blue, because I like blue. It's made out of solid wood, and it's really well constructed. I'm really impressed with that. We've got 2 6.5-inch speakers, 2 2-inch tweeters, and it sounds great. I'm really surprised at the bass response that this delivers. In fact, I still have the settings for this when I did go outside, and it says input 1, but I think of it as channel A. You can almost see that I rolled off a lot of the bass. All right, so let's talk about what you get. You get two channels. They call it input 1, input 2, 40 watts each. And I think of input 1 or channel A, which it doesn't say. It's just the way my mind's thinking, like a guitar amplifier. I think of channel A, it's your microphone channel. And you can plug in 2 microphones. By the way, I'll explain in a second, but you can plug in 6 different devices and have them all going on at one time. So it's pretty flexible. But 2 inputs for microphones. Input 2 would be for a dynamic microphone only, which is more applicable for an outdoor gig. And channel or input 1 here on input 1 or channel A, however you see it, it takes a dynamic mic, but it also can take a condenser mic, and you have a phantom power. You have a switch right here to decide if you want phantom power. So that's pretty cool. You go to channel B, which says input 2. There's 2 inputs on input 2 for any kind of electrical instrument like your guitars or bass or keyboards. There is a separate line in, which would be probably more appropriate for a keyboard or a computer. And then you also have BT MP3. So BT for Bluetooth. If you see this socket here, you could put in a thumb drive and play along to your tunes. But on the Bluetooth, you'd connect to your device, and it's kind of cool what they have. This switch always goes back to center. You can do your volume up, volume down, pause, and play. That's kind of cool. Going back to your inputs, you have two here. So if you look at the two channels, input one, input two, you have separate gain controls for each input. And like I said, you could have six going on at one time, so that's nice. On the mic channel, you have reverb. And on the instrument channel, you have chorus and delay and reverb. And they work really well. I hardly had to turn them up, and I felt some space, so that was nice. I wanted to talk about the busking aspect. So here in Las Vegas, there's some killer musicians, and some of them, they do busk, and they do very well. And it was a moving target for a little while, because they would actually bring a like a car battery and find a way to hook that up to their amps or a generator. And if I understand right, the city of Las Vegas said no more generators and no more of those separate car batteries. It had to be built into your amp. And it was a game changer for some of them. I don't know if things have changed since, but yeah, my friends went and bought battery powered amps. For the price point and for what this does, I'm super impressed. It's battery powered, of course. Like I said, 6 to 8 hours. So busking, playing outside, how many times have I been kind of handcuffed because I had to play outdoors? A one song thing or for a wedding or something where there's just no power and you're outside. This would do the trick. All right, so now I'm going to share with you the video of when I open this up and my first impressions. And then we're going to go outside. And as I was setting up outside today, it was beautiful. And Vegas, it was in the 60s, it was nice. And the wind kicked up. So I apologize for the wind. Not my fault, but you're going to hear how I was playing outside. I didn't even hit halfway up on the main volume here. So that tells you how loud it was. It was plenty loud for me. And yeah, hope you like it. So we got input two. Nice. Let's see what happens if I really dime the reverb. Sounds nice. It's a bit bright, but I don't think we'd ever use that much anyway. All right, so now let's add some lows. I'm going to back off some highs. Let's see what we got there. That sounds good. Let's see, gains. So, that really, as far as I'm going at it, as far as how it feels here, added a lot of body just now. I don't have to figure out what those do. Got a pretty intensive manual right there, so I'll figure that all out. Pack that up. One more try. I don't know if you can pick it up, but there's a lot of bass coming out, and I like it. Let's add some chorus. So what's the flavor? All right, and there seems to be delay. Let's try that out. So far, so cool. This is pretty sturdy. All right, so now I'm gonna make friends with this, and then we're gonna take it outside. just seen a face. I can't forget the time or place where we first met. She's just a girl for me, and I want all the world to see we've met. Falling, oh, I'm falling, and she keeps calling me back again. So there you go, cool music. BP40D acoustic amplifier. Check this baby out. I'm happy to have it. And if you like what I'm doing, if I help out anybody, please subscribe and click that button. I'd really appreciate it. I've got a lot of big news and a lot of big ideas. Stay tuned. And until next time, this is Mundo. Aloha.